Hello and welcome to this live streaming from the Tribune Network. I'm Rohit Ban. The country is in the grip of a massive surge in COVID cases. And like other parts of the country, even Punjab has been witnessing a huge surge. Over 7,000 daily caseload that's being reported from different parts of Punjab. The fatalities have also increased in the last 15 to 20 days. And now a terrible piece of news coming in from Patiala, one of the important cities in Punjab, wherein 31 patients being undergoing treatment at one of the main hospitals in the town. All of them COVID have died in the last 24 hours. I'm joined by my colleague, Karan Prakash from Patiala. Karan, first tell us what happened.
Sir, the situation at Government Rajendra Hospital, which is one of the main hospitals of the Punjab, is getting grim day by day. And today also around 31 people died over the past 24 hours at the hospital. Majority of them are above 60, but they have died over the past 24 hours. Yesterday also, the hospital reported a high number of COVID deaths. Yesterday, the count was 26. Today, it's 31. It is the highest since the pandemic. So the situation is getting scarier day by day.
And also, are the hospital telling you, hospital authorities telling you what was the reason behind this death? As has happened in across the country, there have been allegations that, you know, it's because of lack of oxygen. In this particular case, what happened?
As such, at Rajendra, there's no shortage of oxygen because they have their own oxygen plant, mm-hmm. and there has been a regular supply to the hospital. But majority of the patients who have died were critical patients. Most of them were referred from other districts, from as far as Firozpur. And they were critical. Their oxygen level was below 90, what the authorities say. And they died within few hours of admission. Majority of them died after 9 p.m. Till in the morning, and they were critical. They had comorbidity also, right. but there is no shortage of oxygen at Rajendra.
Right. And also, this happens to be, as you mentioned, it happens to be one of the main hospitals in the state. In fact, patients as far as Delhi and other NCR have been coming to Rajendra Hospital. What are the authorities saying? Are they equipped to handle the increasing number of COVID cases in the hospital? Can you hear me, Karim?
Yes, sir.
What I was saying is that, you know, is the hospital equipped to handle the large number of cases coming in?
Yes, sir. The hospital has around 600 beds, right. And around 120 of them are with ventilator supported. But still, the hospital is witnessing a surge, and they are not able to cope up. Currently, around 260 patients are admitted at the hospital. And yes, you are right that people from NCR, Delhi are especially coming for treatment because of the shortage of oxygen. And many of them have died also because they came at a stage which were below the critical level. So people from Haryana also, Karnal, a lot of people have come here because Haryana is also witnessing a shortage of oxygen. So.
Right. And these 260 are COVID patients, right?
Yes, sir. 260 are COVID, and some of them are suspected also. The right. test reports are awaited. Right. But all are, there is a dedicated COVID hospital, so all are COVID patients.
And do we have, as far as the bed availability is concerned, the hospital still has beds available?
Yes, sir. They have two buildings. One we call as MCH building, and there is another building, COVID dedicated building, that is super specialty ward.
Right.
Currently, they are functioning, the only building which is functional is MCH building. But if the need requires, they will make the other building operational.
And also, Karan, this happens to be the Chief Minister's hometown. Tell us about the situation in Patiala overall. What have been the number of cases? Have the authorities been able to cater to the rising numbers?
Sir, the case count is increasing day by day. 2 days before, the district witnessed the highest cases, around 570, they are going. And they have been able to, because majority of them are home isolated, right. But private hospitals are running out of space. They don't have beds, especially L3 beds, right. What we call as critical ICU beds. But they have been trying to extend the bed capacity. at private hospital because people are afraid to come to government sector a little bit. So right now they have been able to manage the situation.
And also, have the authorities been able to implement the social distancing, the COVID norms, or like any part of other states, like cities we witnessed, you know, violations still happening? What is the status there in Patiala?
The police is registering FIR. In a day, they register around 45 FIRs for the COVID night violators.
Right.
And but there was some function in Rajpura, one of the towns in Patiala, where the mayor also, there's a religious, I guess, function. And a lot of people came there without following the COVID norms. But no action has been taken so far.
Okay. But police has filed an FIR or they are still not done?
Not done, it's in that particular case, because there was a few functionaries of district admission were also present. And the mayor was also there, and Patiala mayor. And but no action as of now.
Well, thank you so much, Karam. As you heard, Karam, you know, terrible news which came in from Rajendra Hospital, 31 deaths. But as Karam mentioned, still these COVID violations are happening. The norms are not being strictly adhered to. As you mentioned, a party which was going on where various functionaries were there. The mayor was present, violating all COVID norms. But despite that, no FIR has so far been registered. So a grim situation in Patiala where deaths have been reporting, as has happened in other parts of Punjab. That's something that the Punjab government is worried about. Number of steps have been taken, but the caseload, daily caseload, continues to mount. We'll keep on providing you all the latest updates on the COVID situation in Punjab and other parts of the state through our website, tribuneindia.com. You can also follow us on our other social media platforms like Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram. Meanwhile, thanks for watching.